just, if you're from the media, stop talking to those people and maybe they'll just go away and get wives and stop being on IRC all the time. I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
What?
The media's up yesterday.
Yeah. But they'll hear.
I hear the media left yesterday. I'm not on very good terms with the blonde chick from Tech TV. She wouldn't give me her number. Could you write it down for me?
Phone number is 555-1212.
I think you're lying.
I can confirm that.
Yo, I couldn't pick up the pattern in that number.
Okay.
555-1212. That sounds pretty random, dog. That's my social security number. Okay, now we're going to move on to another topic. Hey,
what's up?
I think he's stepping.
Do you have something to say about my cultural heritage? Do you know what it's like to grow up in the ghetto? Do you know what it's like to walk home from school every day, wonder if you're going to get capped because you're wearing a Red Bull shirt? Yo, you have no idea. I think you need to sit down, son. That's recognized.
Okay, now we're going to talk about some stuff about the computer security industry. Silvio here probably has some interesting things to say since, yeah, he works in the industry. Good guy. I love him like a brother. Let me see, I can't read my...
Okay, I just remembered that.
Okay, The thing is, how many of you think most of the security companies really care about security? Can you, like, see a show of hands? Like, if you think that security companies actually want security, put your hands up right now.
I think I saw one person. I'm not quite two people. I don't know if this is true or not, but...
Okay, who did you see? I think you just spotted the fed.
I don't know, he ran away.
Yeah, Silvio needs a t-shirt for spotting the Fed. Thank you.
This is my dream come true to get one of these t-shirts.
Is the t-shirt coming? Okay. But basically, I'm not speaking for everyone in the security world, like my friend Dave there, but they don't really care about security because, like, if a state of security actually existed anywhere, like, where the fuck would they work? Think about it, it's just sort of, you know, logical. The security industry, you know, they can't get jobs, or they, you know, they can't sell their, you know, $250,000 sniffers unless you go ahead, or there's a state of insecurity, so... Please don't interrupt me again. You will be our end.
The computer security industry, though, is a multi-billion dollar industry, so, you know, it is treated very much like a business model. You know, the ultimate goal of a computer security company isn't to make a secure environment, it's to make, actually, their quarterly, you know, earnings, their quarterly investment. You know, they have VCs, they have, like, their shareholders. These are the people that they're concerned about. They're concerned about their own pockets, not really the security of computers. You know, Microsoft, for example, you know, they're fantastic at, you know, selling stuff. You know, that's great, but, you know, this is what they do. They don't actually write secure software. You know, it's naive to think this is what they do. So I'll pass the mic back to Gobbles.
Yo, I think you might be getting a little bit too philosophical, dog.
Possibly.
Yeah,
these need to return to concrete examples.
It's all wet.
It's okay. You know, I can give examples here. I do work in the computer security industry. This can't be from Microsoft, though, because it's a free t-shirt, so, you know, let's go ahead.
I'm very poor, I accept cash donations from free beer, whatever, find me. What? Alright, okay, anyhow,
you know, a silly question here. Do people not believe that computer security is about, you know, marketing and about making money? Does anyone actually believe this? Like, does he work for open source? Or, you know, does anyone believe this really? Like, you know, does Microsoft, are there vulnerabilities out there that vendors know about that aren't getting fixed or aren't being reported to the public because it's a bad marketing campaign? Is this, you know, is there anyone that doesn't believe this?
We're getting too philosophical and serious here.
I have to
interrupt and move on to the next subject because, no offense, not you, but I realize how boring the whole topic of the security industry is, so we'll talk about some more exciting things. Next we're going to talk about one of the shortest men in security and his project called Project HoneyNet. They're like all against black hats like K2, or he's on the team, whatever. Lance, I heard you're here. Could you come up here, Lance? Lance Spitzner. This is Gobbles calling Lance Spitzner.
Yo, all I can say is, if Lance Spitzner isn't here, you know your enemy.
Yeah, I'm right here.
Doesn't seem to be doing a very good job at knowing his enemy.
Yeah, the guy... So, and what we're gonna do is basically someone's going to deface their official website, and they will have 1 week to come up with the name of the service, locate the vulnerable part of the code, figure out all that was done on their system, and then at the end of the week, we'll see who the experts are. Thank you.
And remember, there's a special prize for anybody who uses buzzwords like NotSled and polymorphic shellcode. I'm all about reading the HoneyNet analyses, you know, the great, some incredible reverse engineers working on the project, just tearing it up.
You might also get
disassembling all sorts of zero-day TASO exploits.
You might also get to win a free HoneyNet movie, if anyone hasn't seen it yet.
Securityfocus.com with a K.
That's a first. That's a K instead of a first C.
Yes.
The second.
If you could remember that. There's been some interesting contributions last night. Someone put Ryan Russell's home directory, a tarball of it. He's the blue boy right here. Can I have like a round of applause for him, please? Whoever did it, it's pretty funny. Like, if the Gobbles t-shirts were here right now, I'd like give you a fucking 1,000 of them. Yeah, I won't spoil the surprise, isn't it, from what I read, but it's pretty funny. Before I get off the subject of Project Hunter, there's a couple things I'd like to point out. They talk about how they've got the best security minds in the world working on their project. They're talking about, you know, how they're going to, you know, discover all this stuff, and so far, is anyone here from Project HoneyNet at all? Anyone have the balls to admit they're admitted with that shit? Anywhere? Oh yeah, you are. Yeah, come on up here. Come on. Mr. Fyodor?
Yo, if you can run strings on a binary, HoneyNet may be for you.
This guy writes Nmap, and I'd just like to say Nmap is a hell of a lot better than it's a hell of a lot better than that at stake X probe stuff for that guy who like did 20 years of research into ICMP. I've got Rainforest Puppy.
We'd like to suggest that. We'd definitely strongly suggest that you continue to use Nmap.
This, if you're from the media, stop talking to those people. Maybe they'll just go away and get wives and stop being on IRC all the time. I'd appreciate it. Thank you.
What?
What's the media about yesterday?
Yeah. But they'll hear.
I hear the media left yesterday. I'm not on very good terms with the blonde chick from Tech TV. She wouldn't give me her number. Could you write it down for me?
Phone number is 555-1212.
I think you're lying.
I can confirm that.
Yo, I couldn't pick up the pattern in that number.
Okay.
555-1212. That sounds pretty random, dog.
That's my social security number. Okay, now we're going to move on to another topic. Hey.
What's up?
I think he's stepping.
Do you have something to say about my cultural heritage? Do you know what it's like to grow up in the ghetto? Do you know what it's like to walk home from school every day, wonder if you're going to get capped because you're wearing a Red Bull shirt? Yo, you have no idea. I think you need to sit down, son. Best recognized.
Okay, now we're going to talk about some stuff about the computer security industry. Sylvio here probably has some interesting things to say since, yeah, he works in the industry. Good guy. I love him like a brother. Let me see, I can't read my...
Okay, I just remembered that.
Okay, The thing is, how many of you think most of the security companies really care about security? Can you, like, see a show of hands? Like, if you think that security companies actually want security, put your hands up right now.
I think I saw one person. I'm not quite two people. I don't know if this is true or not, but...
Okay, who did you see? I think you just spotted the feds.
I don't know, he ran away.
Yeah, Silvio needs a t-shirt for spotting the Fed. Thank you.
This is my dream come true to get one of these t-shirts.
Is the t-shirt coming? Okay. But basically, I'm not speaking for everyone in the security world, like my friend Dave there, but they don't really care about security because, like, if a state of security actually existed anywhere, like, where the fuck would they work? Think about it, it's just sort of, you know, logical. The security industry, you know, they can't get jobs, or they, you know, they can't sell their, you know, $250,000 sniffers unless you go ahead, or there's a state of insecurity, so... Please don't interrupt me again. You will be RM'd.
The computer security industry, though, is a multi-billion dollar industry, so, you know, it is treated very much like a business model.
And what we're going to do is, basically, someone's going to deface on their official website, and they will have one week to, you know, come up with, you know, the name of the service, locate the vulnerable part of the code, figure out all that was done on their system, and then at the end of the week, we'll see who the experts are. Thank you.
And remember, there's a special prize for anybody who uses buzzwords like NopSled and polymorphic shellcode. I'm all about reading the HoneyNet analyses, you know, the great. Some incredible reverse engineers working on the project, just tearing it up.
You might also get
disassembling all sorts of zero-day TASO exploits.
You might also get to win a free HoneyNet movie, if anyone hasn't seen it yet.
Securityfocus.com with a K.
That's a first. That's a K instead of a first C.
Yes.
The second.
If you could remember that. There's been some interesting contributions last night. Someone put Ryan Russell's home directory, a tarball of it. He's the blue boy right here. Can I have like a round of applause for him, please? Yeah, whoever did it, it's pretty funny. Like, if the GOBBLES t-shirts were here right now, I'd like give you a fucking 1,000 of them. Yeah, I won't.
Are there vulnerabilities out there that vendors know about that aren't getting fixed or aren't being reported to the public because it's a bad marketing campaign? Is this, you know, is there anyone that doesn't believe this?
You're getting too philosophical and serious here.
I'm going to have to interrupt
and move on to the next subject. Because, no offense, not you, but I realize how boring the whole topic of the security industry is, so we'll talk about some more exciting things. Next, we're going to talk about one of the shortest men in security and his project called Project HoneyNet. They're like all against black hats like K2, or he's on the team, whatever. I heard you're here. Could you come up here, Lance? Lance Spitzner. This is GOBBLES calling Lance Spitzner.
Yo, all I can say is, if Lance Spitzner isn't here, know your enemy.
Yeah, I'm right here.
Doesn't seem to be doing a very good job at knowing his enemy.
Yeah, the guy...
The ultimate goal of a computer security company isn't to make a secure environment, it's to make actually their quarterly earnings, their quarterly investment. They have VCs, they have like their shareholders. These are the people that they're concerned about. They're concerned about their own pockets, not really the security of computers. Microsoft, for example, they're fantastic at selling stuff. That's great, but this is what they do. They don't actually write secure software. It's naive to think this is what they do. So I'll pass the mic back to GOBBLES.
Yo, I think you might be getting a little bit too philosophical, dog.
Possibly.
Yeah,
these need to return to concrete examples.
It's all wet.
It's okay. I can give examples here. I do work in the computer security industry. This can't be from Microsoft though, because it's a free t-shirt, so let's go.
I'm very poor, I accept cash donations from free beer, whatever, find me. What? Alright,
a silly question here. Do people not believe that computer security is about, marketing and about making money? Does anyone actually believe this? Does he work for open source? Does anyone believe this really? Does Microsoft,